hey, are you looking for the best mods to make you a better, faster rider? I want to show you my top three all-time favorite mods for your dirt bike. And this can work for any dirt bike. So, tip number one is fresh tires. And this may sound dumb to you, but the tires are the first thing touching the ground. And if you don't have good tires, whether it's they're worn out, they don't have knobs, or if it's an old tire and the rubber is hard, it's not going to get good traction. I just had a small accident last week where my front end slid out because I had a fresh tire in the rear, but I didn't make time to replace the front. It had good tread, but it was still old, and the front end just washed out because it didn't have good traction. It can be done on any dirt bike. So if your tires are old or they're worn out, replace them. You don't need to buy the best ones. Just buy the ones that are for your terrain. So whether it's soft, intermediate, or hard terrain, buy the right ones for your dirt bike. Mod number two is your suspension. Yeah, you may have heard this before too, but learning how to set it up yourself can be done pretty cheap, if not free. So you don't need to get it revalved right away necessarily, whether you're doing trail riding or motocross. I lean towards more towards trail riding just because I have more experience with it. I'm a better trail rider than motocross, but setting up the balance of the bike, so getting the ride height right, is going to be your first thing. So if it's sitting low in the rear, the front end's going to be high, it's not going to handle as well. And if it's too high in the rear, then the front end's going to be low and you're not going to have much stability at high speeds. So learn how to set your sag. Actually, before that, I should say you need to get the right spring rate. So most bikes are set up for 150 to 180 pound riders, so that's full-size bikes. So if you're heavier than that or lighter than that, you might want to consider getting stiffer or heavier springs for the forks and shock. And then once you get the bike balanced with the right springs, then you can adjust the clickers, the compression and rebound. If you're afraid of working on the clickers, don't be intimidated. Just write down your settings before you start. So getting the suspension to work better yourself, you'll be able to understand it better, learn what the bike is doing, what you like and don't like, before you go and spend $1,000 on getting it revalved. You want to understand what your bike is doing so that you can better tell the tuner what you want. But having good suspension will make you so much more comfortable. The bike will handle better in cornering, through whoops or the chop or rocks or whatever it is. You just be able to ride faster because you're comfortable on the bike, because it's not getting sideways and kicked around. So that's why it's so important to have proper suspension. All right, and then tip number three, which is the all-time best, is the rider. Yep, learning basic riding technique and mastering it. No one has perfected riding technique. Yeah, you may see the pros and they're amazing, but they didn't start there. And even if you're experienced, it always pays to go back and learn the basics of using the clutch efficiently, being able to balance at low and high speeds, as well as your cornering, just you being able to use your body positioning to leverage the bike so that you can get over objects, obstacles easier, and just being able to be in control of the bike so that the bike is not in control of you. So if you really want to go into depth and learn how to become a better rider quickly, you can take my virtual dirt biker school, which is on motocrosshideout.com. And there I just go into more depth so that you can learn basic riding technique in a way that's easy to understand and put into use today. So, I'm Kelly Faker from Motocross Hideout. Learn more, ride more.